What up, fellas? Welcome to Culture Shock Live, man. I'm Vinny Vegas. How are you? How are you tonight? Jake Ross first. What's up, man? Tonight's an important show. We took the last week or two to kind of see what was going on, gauge what was happening. And it's pretty serious, man. It's pretty damn serious. I've reached out to a few people, and a lot of people have reached out to me, man. A lot of people. Ethan, what's up? Denise, how are you? Jim, what's going on, man? Joey, second. More like fifth. I'll say hi to you guys. Yo. Bro, chill. Hey, guys. I appreciate this, man. If you can all do me one favor. If you're on YouTube, just give the video a thumbs up, and after the video is posted, give it a comment. It helps the video spread more so we can get the word out there on what this guy has done. Notice there's no music. There's no intro. We're just going to get down to business, man. But please give me that thumbs up. I appreciate it. It really helps the video out. I have a special guest tonight. It's someone who was very, very close to Eddie, basically a partner, I would say. I will have him tell you all about it. I appreciate that. Thank you. What's up, man? Carmine says, I was contacted by three more people today who were scammed by Eddie in the amount of somewhere around $4,500. This is bad. I don't even know what to say, man. But I have a couple of messages that I'm going to share with you too that I received just today, let alone the last week of PMs. Not only just messages, but actual screenshots showing payment. Right? Showing. Listen, I paid for this stuff. It's sad. Now I understand, you know, that he's in the hospital. I get that. Trust me. I am not wishing any ill will towards him. I'm not wishing death, Daddy Williams' death. No. But that doesn't alleviate the fact that he's robbed people, that he's hurt people, a lot of people. This isn't one or two mistakes. You know what I'm saying? This is bad. This is a clusterfuck, to put it nicely. It's serious. This goes beyond, oh, he stole my wrestling belt. Oh, he didn't go through with the trade. That happens, man. People fall on hard times, right? They do something they shouldn't have. They get away with it. What are you going to do? Right? But this time, Eddie screwed Eddie. That's all I can say. So I'm not here to worry about people's feelings. I don't give a fuck. I give a fuck about the people in this community that got fucked. That's what I give a fuck about. And if you don't agree, it's fine. You can click off. But if you want to sit down and really hear some things and come up with a conclusion yourself, you're more than welcome to. But like I said, I'm not worried about people's feelings. Plain and simple. Ladies and gentlemen, I bring to you a good friend of mine, Mr. Eric Tyler. How are you, Eric?
Good, but having really appreciate the platform and the time.
No problem, man. I gave you a little applause there. How are you doing, Eric? I mean, it must have been a wild couple weeks for you.
Pain, confusion, hurt, and a lot of things that a lot of other people are feeling. You know, it's not just one of us, two of us, 10 of us, 12 of us. It's hundreds of us that we're finding out are going through this.
Right. You heard me say, Eric, that, you know, this isn't a one-off. This isn't a two-off, man. This is bad.
hobby's never seen before. I've been in this hobby for over 25 years, mm-hmm. and we've never seen something at this scale.
Is it that bad? Is it that bad?
It is that bad.
Okay.
No one has ever done what that person has done to the good people in this hobby.
Right. Right. Let's get started, Eric. How did you meet Eddie? And how did your relationship kind of start as far as a partnership, I would say?
Well, not really a partnership. It was more just like a, you know, mutual. I went into the Myon page. I found the Myon page. And at that time, they were, the Myons, I believe, were doing like a little birthday cake type thing for Eddie.
Okay.
All the workers were there and they were celebrating his birthday. And I was like, oh, that's nice, man. You know, that's nice that you get along with the people that you're doing business with. You know, and it was just, you know, cordial stuff here and there. And then eventually one evening my phone rings.
Okay.
Of who would call me at this hour of night? And I answer the phone. Hello. Oh, hey, brother, it's Eddie. Eddie who? Eddie from the Belt Group. Oh, thinking to myself, how in the world did you get my number? I was like, okay, yeah, sure. Hey, man, what's going on? He's like, I just wanted to talk and just talking and everything, blah, blah. So we talked for a while and we talked about, you know, just different belts and different things. And over time we would just talk, you know, here and there. And he would ask, you know, for advice or a photo on something. And that's kind of how like the whole thing just kind of went into being.
Okay.
I was
so
there.
You,
wasn't, you know.
He reached out to you.
I mean, the things that he was doing with the maker.
He reached out to you.
Yes.
Okay. And I guess he just noticed you in the belt group, right? In the Myon belt group. Just so you guys know, Eric, I'm not displaying any comments right now. I see them, but I'll engage with you guys after Eric's done because we have a couple of other things to get to as well. But I see you guys. This is just for him. Okay. So when did you start getting involved with the business aspect of Myon belts?
Again, not really the business aspect as much as getting questions about was there a belt at this point in time? What did it look like?
That, gotcha.
You know, images and stuff like that, which I was thinking, you know, hey, it's being sent to, you know, the makers, because I didn't really know them until later on. Mm-hmm. Thinking that, you know, how those images are going to help them to help make the belt.
Okay. So you were just helping him out. You weren't really a partner. You weren't in business with him.
Thing came, there was nothing given, nothing, you know, no contract, no nothing, no agreement, no nothing.
Okay. So you were just helping out a guy you thought was your friend.
Right. I was helping out somebody, you know, as we do in the hobby, you try to help each other, you know, and help it grow in a positive way.
All right. I will say this to you, Eric. I see Rusty in there and he's saying, Eric is a brother. I've known him for 20 years and I've done many deals with him.
Rusty is so true. Many, many years. Some of the first trades I did was with Rusty.
I didn't even realize you were in the hobby that long. I had no clue.
Back in the days of belt, the original belt talk and Glory in the Gold and some of the other Yahoo message board groups. Yes, absolutely. Okay.
So you start helping him with artwork.
Mm-hmm. Just basically those and stuff he would ask about. Is there a clearer photo of this? Is there any kind of special tooling or anything on this?
Okay. Did he offer you anything for that?
No.
Okay. So you were just doing it as a friend?
As a friend.
Okay. I guess it came to where he would ask you for favors, right?
Well, at one point, the one favor he would ask me for as I was working, I said, let me call you back because I'm still at work. I get home, I call him back. Hey man, what's going on? I need to ask a favor. Can I process some PayPal payments through you? I'm like, yeah, I'll do it for a little bit, but I'm not doing it for a long time. So like a few, and not a whole bunch because I don't have the time for it. And I just don't want to be involved and stuff like that. That's not my thing.
Okay.
I like to be a collector here and there and, you know, in and out of the hobby and, you know, help people with what they're looking for. Mm-hmm. Well, everything's fine. No problems. Nothing going on that I know of. Then the day of the mass exodus of Myon belts begins.
Okay. So when the Myon fallout happened, about approximately how many PayPal payments did you take for him?
I took a handful.
Handful. And then how would you give him the money?
Cash App.
So you sent it to him, not to Mayan.
Correct.
Okay. He would tell you to do that.
Yes. I said, well, what do I do? And he says, you just send the Cash App because mine's full right now. I'm doing too much with PayPal. And I said, well, it has to be a few and it has to be very few.
Okay. So you would say a handful.
He wanted me to do Western Union before. And I told him, no, I don't like Western Union. I wouldn't do all that. It's a pain in the butt. He says, I respect you for that.
What were the average amounts he was asking you to do for him?
I would get like somebody going in and wanting to do like a single, like one belt. So like, you know, the 325, you know, whatever it was at the time at the beginning. Mm-hmm. Prices did change.
So you were doing a handful. What was the largest amount that you can recall that you did for him?
The largest amount, which I had one person do, which I ended up having to do a claim on, which was 1,900 and something.
So almost $2,000. Mm-hmm. Okay. So I'm going to let you continue. The exodus happens, the fallout, right? Well,
my on belt happens. I wake up that morning, not in the group. Okay. Look around. Nope. Not in the group, but the group is there. Message Eddie. Hey, Eddie, what's going on? What's up with the group? Man, I don't know. I woke up and everybody was gone and da 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 da. And then I messaged Mayan and he's yelling about, I need my pocket money and I don't care about your mother-in-law with her, whatever her issue was going on supposedly. And so it was all that going on at the time. And so I just kind of, you know, okay, the group is gone or disbanded, whatever it may be. Mm-hmm. I'm going to, you know, just wait this out. Couple days pass, maybe 48 hours or so. Claims start popping up.
Oh, no.
Eddie, what's going on? I'm getting all these claims. What's up? Some of them are just raffle people, and they're mad because they didn't get their win, so they just probably want their raffle. And, okay, fine. So if they win, they're going to get it anyway. I'm going to make sure. So pay off that one to the tune of a little over 200. Then the huge one pops up that you and I just spoke of. I immediately message Eddie. Eddie, I don't have that kind of money, bro. I live from paycheck to paycheck. Mm-hmm. I take care of my family, bro. They're old. I take care of them. I got a mortgage. I got all kinds of stuff that I have to deal with in life.
Right.
Oh, don't worry, brother. We'll take care of it. We'll get it done. Well, to me, we'll get it done without telling me, you know, hey, here's, you know, X amount to help you get through this. No, I'm not going to play that. So I called a friend of mine who said, hey, if you ever need anything, give me a call. You need extra work, give me a call. So I call him. Mm-hmm. Said, hey, can you use me? I need some work and I need to start as soon as possible.
What's your PayPal at right now?
My PayPal is finally, I paid it all off. We'll get to that.
Point. No. I mean, at this moment in time where you're talking about.
All the debt is paid off.
No. When you called your friend and you had the negative, where was it negative?
Plus.
What was it?
It was at the 2,000 plus. Because
2,000 plus negative. Okay, go ahead.
Okay, sorry.
No, you're fine.
So I call him. I said, hey, you know, can you use me and do some work? Absolutely. Anytime you want. I said, can I start tonight?
Oh my God.
Yeah, he says, it's only a few hours away. He says, get some rest and, you know, get up in the morning. And we'll start delivering papers. So I delivered papers 7 days a week on top of having a 40-hour a week, five-day a week job. Sleeping 2 hours a night, get up, go do papers. Sleep another 2 hours and maybe a tiny bit more than that, get up and go do my regular job.
And at the same time, Eric, I want you to explain to the people, okay, mm-hmm. what you go through in a daily basis as far as taking care of your family.
I oversee anything that they could possibly need. They're getting older. It's getting harder for them to do things for themselves. Sometimes it's just little things. Sometimes it's big things. You know, it changes from day to day. Sometimes memory is not so good for one of them or both of them. And that's why I'm so glad if I'm not here that they have each other. They've mm-hmm. got cell phones. They can get a hold of me. They know that we've got some neighbors that will come in a heartbeat mm-hmm. if I'm here. So, you know, it's stressful.
Your life revolves around taking care of them.
They are my life. I love them. You know, our parents spend their beginning of their adult lives, when they have us, they take care of us and they do everything for us. It's so important, at least I feel it's important, that as they get older, we need to do the same for them.
Right.
They did it for us. We need to be able to do it for them.
Right.
So, kind of in a nutshell, that's what went on. Well, I'm now working these two jobs, getting money in every week. As I'm looking at things in that point, that first week working that other night job, I'm like, I can't even cut it all the way quick enough. How do I do this? And the only thing I could come up with is I have to sacrifice all the money I have, everything. So pulled all the money I had and still didn't have enough. I still had an outstanding balance. I think a little under 1,000, maybe. Mm-hmm. Sorry, this is hard to talk about.
No, take your time, man. It's okay.
So did that. And eventually making payments every week, making as much of a payment as I possibly could just to make sure that, you know, they had stuff. Eventually PayPal says, hey, you know, you haven't made all of it as quickly as we want you to make it, so we're going to shut down the account. Now I'm freaking out because some of my bills go through PayPal, like my water and my electric. So I'm trying to still scramble and do as much as I can. Now I'm thinking, okay, what do I need to do? The only thing, I can do is pull money out of what I'm putting into me, which is food. Fine. So I buy several cans of tuna, and that's what I eat for the next 2.5 months while my water and my power are off at the beginning portions of what is getting ready to be the summer. Making sure that my family has what they need in any way possible. I was bringing home bags of ice and putting them in coolers. Anything I could do, giant jugs of water to make sure they had fresh water. All this extra stuff. And the whole time, Eddie knew what was going on. I told him, I'm like, man, I got to have it. I got to get this power back on. I need you to please do your part. As a friend, I need you to do your part. Oh, brother, we'll take care of it. Don't worry. We're going to set up. I said, no, we're going to set up a payment plan. I said, every Friday, I need you to make a payment to the payment plan. And I need you to start with something, you know, somewhat significant to help me get everything back on track here.
Let me interrupt you, Eric. So you're at negative 2,000. Okay. Your electric is off.
Yes.
Your water is off. And you take care of your parents.
Yes.
In the summer with ice and bottled water. Eddie knows this and doesn't give a fuck.
Doesn't give a damn. It gets better.
I want you all to understand something. I've seen the chats. I've seen everything. And they're not screenshots. They're actually scrolled videos. They're
scrolled videos with audio and portions.
And those audios that he records to think that people don't know what the fuck he's doing, you hear him. He's a piece of shit. Keep going, Eric.
So we get to that point. I'm doing tuna fish every day for 2.5 months, basically. He hasn't started doing anything. Eventually, he starts making a payment. He made one payment, which was like 200 and something. It got somewhere. I didn't get very much. And I said, you know, every week, you got to make a payment. Every week for a few times. Then every week became every 2 weeks. Oh, brother, I can't do as much every week because I'm trying to get all these makers on board and trying to take care of them and take care of all these back orders for people. From the what he says, quote unquote, but my unscrewed everybody. And real quick, Eddie, you screwed everybody, not Mayon. And there's proof. Thank you. After that happened, we got into trying to just, you know, get a payment every week. Mm-hmm. Oh, brother, I can't pay that much every week. Well, Eddie, how much can you pay, man? I need something of significance. I got to start putting it back where it needs to be. This is what we live off of. Right now, I can only do $50 a week, brother. $50.
$50 fucking.
$50, and you run a business.
Six figures,
which I didn't hear about that until later on.
And Eric, I want you to understand something. In the meantime, guys, while Eric is struggling to get electric and water, okay, and I see the chats, and this is the most fucking patient human being I've ever met in my fucking life. Because when I scroll through these things, softly reminds him, hey, Eddie, listen, I just need that payment tonight. Sending him pictures. This man sent him action figures for his kids. When he had no money, he still did it. Because he gave a fuck. He cared. But guess who didn't make that payment that night? Eddie. And in the meantime, he's on his shows, right? Flexing. Yep. Yo, I just bought $9,000 worth of shoes, man. And six-figure job, man. Got my Jordan card, man. Fuck you. Go ahead.
So eventually we get to that point. I'm dealing with all that. PayPal starts sending physical letters. Need to get it faster, blah, 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 the typical stuff. Text Eddie. Eddie, really need your help here. They're sending physical letters. This is getting crazy. I'm so close to getting the account back open, but I need the help. Please, please, please. Oh, brother, I'll get to it. Well, I promise you. I'll get to it. Promises were just as good as before. Pretty much didn't get anything. Well, at this point now, I've decided in my head that I need to at least wait it out and try to get as much as I can back before trying to get away from him. In the meantime, I'm starting to see certain things that he can't hide. Anybody, Vinny, you probably know from being in chats with Eddie.
Yep.
He's very good if you ask a question about making a comment. I would say, where's so-and-so? I haven't seen them. Oh, they're a clown. They're a snake. Oh, yeah? What happened? You know, man, just how they are. And then he changes the subject.
Yeah.
So you couldn't get any information. And when you guys disappeared, I really had questions. I wanted to know where my friends were. And some of y'all know I got some friends in PTM. Mm-hmm. Some of them are very good friends, and some of them, you know, we're slight acquaintances, but we grow with each other, like all people do when they talk. I didn't let that go the entire time because I knew he knew something and he didn't want to tell. Because if he told, even if he told me, the house of cards comes falling down.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I eventually get the account back opened. Everything is rolling kind of in a positive direction. I'm still trying to get the money. I start to see him asking other makers to do things. And I'm seeing it in live time, like you guys are seeing it. Like, okay, what's going on here? You had a Seif and you wanted to use Arham. And I said, Eddie, what's going on with this? I said, thought these were your guys. You wanted to do a little bit with a Seif on, you know, a Seif up here and have him, you know, you be his guy. And then Arham was like your guy for other stuff. Yeah, I think that's how I'm going to do it. But I don't know. I might have to let Arham go. I think I'm going to work with Shazam, whatever his name is. And okay, cool. But do it the right way, man. Just, you know, be cool. But, you know, whatever it is, that's your thing. You know, that's kind of your deal. You do you. By the way, don't forget the payment on Friday. Every week. I was like clockwork. And I would remind him a couple of days beforehand, don't forget.
Not once, let me interrupt you, Eric. Not once through the entire fucking chat. And this is, when I'm talking the entire chat, this is the entire chat. It was like five video files, right? Not once did Eddie go, hey, Eric, your payment's there. This guy had to ask him every single time, multiple times, while his electric is off and his water is off. Go ahead.
Here's the kicker. One time I call to try to get one of those payments while everything is off, and it still rings in my head. He's like, hey, man, what's going on? Oh, nothing much, man. I just wanted to make sure that you don't forget to send the payment tonight when you have a chance. I know you're busy, but, you know, I just wanted to remind you because I don't have much power left on my phone, so I might not answer right away. He's like, oh, man, I won't forget. I won't forget it. I'm waiting on my DoorDash guy. I'm like, thanks. Waiting on your DoorDash guy. Number one, I didn't know you owned DoorDash. He's your DoorDash guy.
Nice.
Number two, you want to tell somebody that's been eating tuna fish out of a can for 2.5 months. I'm just waiting for my DoorDash guy.
Nice.
Good God.
Nice.
No heart. No brotherhood.
So the last payment you got from him, when was that?
November.
What was your balance at that point?
The balance at was like $1,600 plus.
$1,614, guys. Let me show you something.
Go ahead, show it to him.
This here is the final payment from six-figure Eddie Williams for $36.
36 doesn't look very much like 50, does it?
When they agreed to 50 a week for $2,000 to be paid back. While this guy is still robbing Peter to pay Paul. All living large, right? No. $36 fucking. $36. In November. November 6th. Right before Christmas. Isn't that great? Great guy of the hobby, huh? Cool dude, isn't he? Nice guy. Honest, transparent. Bullshit. When I heard this story, it broke my heart. Okay? Broke my heart. I told a couple of the Culture Shock guys. I told Carmine. I told a few people. Talked to Dustin. Good. It bothered me the whole day the next day. It just bothered me. Once again, this isn't hobby stuff. This isn't hobby drama. That's why I keep telling you guys this. This is not hobby drama. This is real fucking life. This is a guy that ate tuna with two disabled parents with no electric and no water for 2 months. That's real life. That's not hobby drama. He was taken advantage of. His kindness was taken advantage of. His friendship was taken advantage of. And for that, Eddie gets a big fuck you. We're not done. So what we did was, you know what? I told the guys, I was like, we got to do something, right? We got to do something to help him out. He's struggling. He never once asked for help. Never once. He took it upon himself to work two jobs while he's disabled himself. And took care of his parents. Didn't say a peep to anybody. Didn't say a peep. Okay? Let me show you something. So what I did was I sent Eric some money. Ethan, some of the Culture Shock guys, sent him some money. Dustin said, what's his Cash App? He's getting $250 tonight. And Dustin did that. Didn't need me to say any more. So last night, what I did was I set up a GoFundMe. And the reason why I chose a GoFundMe is because it's totally transparent. And the only one that can access those funds is Eric. I don't do raffles and give him the money. Hey, let's raffle off a belt and give the proceeds to charity. Let's do that, right? Believe me. No, it's fully transparent for everyone to see. if you guys want to help Eric, which I really, really hope you want to, and if you can't, I understand. It's just after Christmas, right? But if you can, I just ask you to do so. I made a short URL here, tinyurl.com/Eric Tyler. Once again, that's tinyurl.com/Eric Tyler. The amount that I put in, the goal amount, is $1,614, the balance that Eddie left for him to deal with in November. So Eric went through Christmas, okay, with nothing. And GoFundMe takes so much. That's okay, because hopefully we could break that goal, but I want it to be totally transparent. I'm not doing anything to where there could be a crack. No, this all goes to him. It all goes to him. And Eric, I know that you held out because you were hoping that, you know, hell would freeze over and Eddie would actually understand that he's being an asshole and give you the money you needed, that he owed you.
Yes. He owed my family. He didn't owe me. I don't even look at it as he owed me. He owed my family.
Rusty said he will cash app you right now. Eric, if you want to send him your cash app after the show, okay?
Thank you,
Rusty. We are here to help you.
Thank you.
We are here to help actual people that are in need. I want to ask you one more thing. All right, before I let you go, and
I need to cover something else before we finish it out.
But, go for it. Go for it, Eric. Go ahead.
First,
all yours.
We'll go yours first, and then we'll go mine.
No, go for it. I want you to go. Go ahead. Okay.
To our hobby, each of you, all of us, were separated by one individual who gained power and wanted more. He wanted control of our hobby, not his hobby, our hobby. I don't care if you buy a cardboard belt or the most expensive belt on the planet and all the ones in between. All of you have a voice. All of you have a right to be heard. No one should silence you at all. That's to you guys. Now to the makers. Makers, I apologize, I can't speak in your language, so I will try to keep it simple for you. Please communicate with each other. Don't let someone do bad things to you. If you don't trust the person you are working with, please, please talk to others. See what they know. It never hurts to ask a question. That's it. Thank you.
Eric, I have one more thing I want to ask you. Out of all this that you went through, okay, a lot of people are asking, can they pay you through Cash App, or do you take PayPal? Guys, listen, I don't know if GoFundMe, does that take PayPal? Thumbs up, guys. Can they use their PayPal to do? Okay. If you want to do PayPal, do it through the GoFundMe. We want this fully transparent. We want this done the right way. We would prefer that. Cash App. Eric, what's your Cash App if they prefer Cash App?
Cash App. I will send that to you in just a second.
And I'll post it. I'll post it. Send it, message it to Ethan, and we'll post it on the Pounding the Meat Facebook group, Brothers of the Belt, along with the real Brothers of the Belt, along with the URL for the GoFundMe. We're going to post that everywhere, guys. If you can't give, it's okay.
Just the thought, anybody, okay. Even if you just, you know.
Don't worry about it. I understand. Everyone goes through hard times, okay?
That, you know, you guys want to or you can't. The fact that you guys care enough to even just want to and even can't.
Right.
That means the world.
Right. All right. So understand this is something to where we're saying you need to give. No, no, no. This is something that if you can, if you have the ability to, this is a good cause. This isn't a raffle. Okay. We want to do it the right way. Out of everything you've gone through, I want to ask you something, Eric.
Go ahead.
What positive way can you spin this whole situation, this whole scenario you went through? What is the bright side to this?
The bright side is we learned what a con man can do. We have found things now through this that we didn't know before existed, such as getting control through all of these groups, finding a way to not allow others to have a voice and silencing those that he disagreed with. We're not going to let that happen anymore. We are the heroes we've been waiting for. If we've learned anything from this, it's we've learned that we need to take this negative and learn from it. And we need to stop tearing down each other, listen to each other, build each other up. And that makes our hobby better, because every minute of every day, someone else finds our hobby for the first time. And we want them to stay and be a part of it, not run away from it, never to come back again. Let's grow our hobby. Let's grow our friendships. And let's make this place better than it was before Eddie Williams ever stepped foot inside our hobby.
Eric, I love you, man. Good job.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. Eric, everybody, Eric Tyler, let's give him a little round of applause, man. Took a lot of courage for you to do this. I appreciate it. And I want you people to understand something. He did this because he did this knowing Eddie ain't going to send him the $1,600. Okay. And it's already at $370, Eric.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you.
All right. More will come. People will give. We'll get the word out there. You did the right thing. You helped a lot of people right now. Hopefully this video, everyone like this video, get it out there, share it so people can help him. Okay.
Thank you.
You cool, Ben? You good?
I'm good. And one last thing.
Go ahead.
Everybody that came and did the Day of Reckoning on BAM, you guys were the ones that gave me the strength to do what I needed to do. You guys are the ones who gave people the strength to do what they needed to do. Never think any less of yourselves. You guys are heroes to this hobby, and we thank you so much for what you did. It may seem small to you, but it was ginormous to all of us that were affected. We thank you, and we love you.
Eric, we love you, man. Good job. Good job. I'll talk to you tonight, okay? I'm going to let you go.
Bless.
All right, buddy. God bless. I'll talk to you. Bye. Eric Tyler, man. There he is. If you can help, tinyurl.com/Eric Tyler. This is everyone. If you can, just give whatever you can. $5. It goes a long way, okay? It really helps him out. I have one more special guest, and I'm going to bring on the guys, and we're going to discuss some things because we got a couple more stories. All right. Now, this one here is a little bit of a, there's going to be a language barrier, but I'm going to do the best that I can. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, I bring to you Kirban Ali. Is he there? I don't know. There he is. Kirban, how are you? He's breaking up. If we can, we'll get him on Facebook. I don't think the video is going to work too well, but Kirban Ali is here and he's going to go through a couple things on what happened. First and foremost, let me bring the guys up. Kirban, if you can, I'm going to call you on Facebook Messenger. We'll just do an audio of it and we'll go from there. Joey V, Ethan, what is going on, man? Wow.
When we heard this story initially the other night, you did gutted me. You know, we talked,
I'll be right back. You two talk for a little bit on your reaction, okay. Ethan and Joey, and I'm going to get him on the phone. Guys, someone, the GoFundMe is going up. This is insane. You guys are fucking awesome. I'll be right back. Let me see if I can get Kirban on, okay?
Yep.
Be right back.
Never thought I'd see the day of us two
Right. Alone. You know, it is, but it's one of those things is like when the story came up the other day, it was, I mean, it literally blew me away. Cause you know, he's bathing his disabled parents with bottles of water. Cause he has no water, and the lack of disregard for humanity that was displayed. And I understand that somebody's sick and, but your current circumstances isn't an escape and isn't an excuse. So you've reaped what you sow. And with Eric, man, like what's really happened, if you've noticed, it's brought a lot more people together than you think. Because, you know, there was a lot of passerbys. You know, I talked to Eric once or twice. You know, I've seen Brody around and Reginald Paul Hawk, all these people that, and now I see their stories and, you know, they message you and it's dumbfounding, honestly. That's the best way. I never thought I would see this level of scam go on. But not only that, though, the community. So the community is showing their face right now for Eric. And with Eric, man, like, that dude is an unconditionally great dude. You know, we've all had our run-ins with people in this hobby, but that Eric's just not that dude. He's not that guy. Yeah, I'm just blown away, honestly. Thank you guys for donating. I mean, it means more to us and him than you'll understand.
I've had conversations with Eric off and on when I was still talking to Eddie. And I understand Eric's situation. I could relate to Eric's story more than other people because I was that same person. Eddie would call you, he would strike up a conversation, get you to, you know, like think like, oh, he's calling to talk to you. And then he would say, hey, brother, the reason why I'm calling is someone bought a belt and can I use your PayPal? And what he would say is like, yo, can I use your PayPal? I would go through Eric, but you know, he's giving me the story.
I'm in a bind right now.
Yeah.
We all got that. And
yeah,
that's the thing.
And like, I would have people send me the money via PayPal and then I would cash up with Eddie. And I have proof that I sent the money to Eddie. Now people did pay me, friends and family. There's only one person I know that did not get their belts that I know of. And I feel really bad for that person. And I showed him proof that I sent it to Eddie and everything. And I mean, it tore me up this week hearing about his situation. Then Eric's situation, like, man, I wish I didn't go to bed that night. I wish I would have stayed up, you know. But, you know, we like to talk to like 3 or 4 in the morning, even though you got to be at work the next day, you know, it's how culture shock is. Sorry. but I mean, it's just tough. And if anybody wants to still. Sorry about my voice, still don't got it back. But if anybody in this hobby or this community still wants to back Eddie and still be like, well, you know, I'm still Eddie's been good to me. Then you know what? I have no use for you. I'm sorry. And people saying like, leave his kids out of it. His kids have nothing to do with it. This is all him.
Yep.
I mean, what he's doing, he's going to reap what he sold and karma's going to come back twofold. And it already is. Sick or not sick. If somebody dies, their debt goes on to their family.
Yep.
So whether you like it or not, if something happens to him, his debt's going to go on to his family. And people may not like that, but that's the reality of the situation. And he is going to get his due because I'll tell you this, for me and a lot of people on this screen and a lot of people in this community, if it was us, we would make a house call.
That's true.
And not 100%. Think twice about it.
I want to share something from Bill Bowles today. This is the message he sent me and he okayed me to say this. Okay. Hey, I'm yet another guy that was scammed by Eddie. Over $1,200. These stories that he would tell when he was doing these weekly updates were utterly ridiculous. He was trying to sell belts that I ordered through that update, claiming that he had them in hand for other people, all while making me wait even longer. I'm just writing to tell you in case you need another person to tell their story. It sounds like you have plenty, though. We never have plenty.
No.
We never have plenty. There's so what Eddie would do is he would charge people the money to order belts. He would get some of those belts, but they weren't for the customer. No, he would double dip on them. He would say, I got some in hands. Who wants them? Meanwhile, Mon's busting his fucking ass trying to fulfill these orders that he's getting. He's not even getting all the orders, by the way. He's only getting some. And if Kirban Ali can't come back, I'm going to have him on a separate show. We might just do that, actually.
Okay.
We might just do that.
You know what I've seen also with Eddie? I saw a guy. He won a raffle win, a belt. A month later, Eddie was selling that exact same belt that the guy won in a raffle. And the guy never received his belt. But that's just the type of scum that he would.
Let's go a step further. Let's take somebody we all know in this hobby, Gianni Martello. Gianni Martello went down and visited him. They went to lunch. Gianni had a belt he was buying from Eddie. This is how much of a scam he ran. Gianni bought a belt from Eddie. Eddie told Gianni he forgot it at his house in his town, but wouldn't allow Gianni to go to his house and pick up the belt. Said he'd ship it Monday. Still hasn't got the belt. Yeah. Like,
yeah. Let me turn some of these comments on for you guys so we could see what's going on here. There we go. The GoFundMe apparently is still growing, guys. Thank you, like I said, give what you can. This is awesome. And shout out to Dustin and for what he did. He didn't even make an announcement about it. Nothing. Right now it's at $1,147. $1,147.
You guys are fucking phenomenal.
I'm sending Eric money right now via Cash App.
Bro, $1,147.
Because nobody told me about this.
This was a surprise. We wanted it to be quiet. Yeah. No one knew.
I wanted to send money, you know.
We got to do it, bro. Now's the time. We want to unite, okay, and help this guy out. Kirban, I'm going to try this one more time. If it doesn't work, we'll have you on. I'll do it next show. We'll have make sure it's a good connection and get you. Kirban, are you there? I don't think it's going to work. It's not looking good. Yeah, no, it's not working. Jones, if you can, just message Kirban, tell him we'll have him on next week. And we'll go through what actually happened with the Mayan situation. Okay. If you guys can do one thing for me, join a few groups. Okay. Join a few groups. I want you to join, first off, the Pounding the Meat podcast private group. Join in. We'll get you in there. We're going to post some things in regards to Eric and his GoFundMe. We're going to post some screenshots of new stories. As people give me permission to post the stories, I'll post them there. Also join the new Brothers of the Belt. It's all caps. Brothers of the Belt. Join that one. All right. Everyone's still posting their stories in there. Once again, if you think it's drama, don't join. Whatever. If you want to be drama free, then don't join it. It's no big deal. And it's join HWB. HWB. HWB.
It's not drama. It's all fun and love. Not like the other fake one.
But this was heart-wrenching for me to hear originally. This is incredible. Mayan Belts is here. Mayan Belts, we'll have you guys on next week. Is that cool with you? We'll get this situated and see if we can have you on. Franklin says, I want to send a belt and donate. And Franklin just got a new job, and he's still willing to sacrifice a belt. That's awesome, man.
You know what's crazy? Like, when I went to Mayan to get my two belts, Mayan took care of me. And he showed me a video of everybody's belts packaged with their name on it. And some of those people's names on there, I'm not going to say the names, but those were the same people that were riding with Eddie that were calling Mayan a scammer, that were saying shit about PTM and all this stuff. We still kept a list of your names. We know who you are. Don't double dip now. I'm not hearing it. But Mayan made good on people's orders.
Shout out to Mayan, honestly.
Yes. And what Mayan is doing right now, Mayan told me, he said, I want to thank you guys for clearing my name.
Yeah.
And that's when he invited me to be an admin of his page. And I said, yes, I will.
We're gonna do a show on the whole Mayan situation next week. We're going to do it next Thursday on Culture Shock Live. We have a lot of information that was given to me by Curebon and Madasser. We're going to go through it all. We're going to show you exactly what Eddie did with them and how they figured it out. Carmine says it's now at $1,237 fucking dollars.
Wow. Man. Beautiful.
I'm sure Carmine will post the GoFundMe on their BAM show, which is what, Saturday?
Saturday.
Saturday night. Tune in. Let's unite this hobby a little bit.
Yes.
Okay. Let's you know, look at my three little princesses on screen, all done up on a Wednesday.
What's up, the
club goes up on a Tuesday, but on Wednesday we here, bro.
Hey man, we're ready for the private show, man. With the
come
poll,
on, Brian. You know the fuck.
Brian knows how we get turned.
Yeah, I want to say
it's funny
this
how it's on the same day as an update.
Yeah,
the update. This is the real fucking update.
Yeah, yeah. Right? I don't know, man.
Come on.
I wish I was never on that show. Eric, after you get this GoFundMe, and I hope it keeps going. Once you get everything settled in, I want you to take your parents to a nice steak dinner, man.
For real, bro. Hey, I'm down with that, man. I'm down with that. Yeah, Carmine, thank you. And you know what? Shout out to Carmine for bringing this to the forefront as well, man. Shout out to the BAM crew.
Carmine's two people. You either love him or you fucking hate him. Right? That's Carmine.
And you could do that in one day.
You can. Me and Joey have done it multiple times. You know, but you know, he's got a big mouth and, you know, it works sometimes.
You get him into a chat at night, man. I'm telling you, man. He's like a gentle kitty cat.
Shout out to Randall Angel.
Yes.
Yes.
Gustavo of HWB. Gustavo. Jim Rogers.
Yes.
Okay. Shout out to Dustin King.
Yes.
Ben Walker.
Yes.
For what they've done. Shout out to Nick Carnivale.
Yes.
Chris Stratton.
Yes.
For going on their phone and saying, I don't give a fuck. I'm going to be real and tell you guys what the fuck's going on.
Yes.
Guys, if you don't feel comfortable telling your stories publicly because you're afraid there's still a chance maybe you'll get your belt, I don't think it's going to happen. Get the news out there, man. Help other people. Why not?
And we are going to make sure that even if Eddie comes back to this hobby and he tries to go to another maker, we're going to do everything we can to stop that, to make that not happen.
Don't worry, guys. This isn't the next few weeks aren't going to be all Eddie, but
no.
It's a big deal. As you can see, more and more is coming out. It's a big deal.
But Eric had to be told.
Oh yeah.
Eric's story had to be told and had to be told individually because I know we all get confused on, you know, well, I didn't get my belt. So Eric wasn't getting belts. He was helping what he thought was a friend. Yes. And we were all scammed by that same person for friendship.
Right.
Everybody on the screen and people behind the scenes were scammed through a friendship. And he used that. And Eric's story was one of those stories that, like, it's just a human story. It had to be told.
Right.
I mean,
I will say one more thing. Eddie wasn't alone. Eddie wasn't alone.
No,
not by a long shot.
Okay. Now, Eddie was the one stealing from our peers. Okay. Our brothers. our peers, the Belt Brothers. But Josh Hammer was involved with stealing from Makers as well.
Yep.
Okay. Bet. So this whole thing of, oh, I'm just going to demote him from admin to member.
Now, did he steal from Newman Ali?
Come on, Josh. We know what you're doing, too. And sooner or later, that's going to come out.
And you ain't safe either, man. And I don't care if anybody in this comments wants to say, oh, don't go after Josh.
No. Nah.
Forget you. Mind your business. It's happening.
Yep. Go ahead.
Because let's go two ways. Well, first thing on the Josh thing. I've been in this hobby almost 3 years going on there now. Yep. And this godfather of the hobby, all I've seen he gets called it, but I haven't seen anything. He runs raffles, so it is what it is. But I do have a question that somebody would like brought up. And the question is, so do we hold Eddie's current makers in any extent like Asif? Asif is Eddie's maker and Eddie's current maker. Mm-hmm. Should we hold the makers associated with Eddie accountable for a certain extent?
Joey, what do you think?
I would say, you know, this is a tricky situation. I was going to say no, but then I see people message Asif about their orders. And Asif is like, oh, talk to Eddie. I'll send the belt to Eddie and I won't send it to you and stuff like that. So like Eddie is being loyal to us. I mean, Asif's being loyal to Eddie because Asif thinks he's going to get paid.
I love you too,
bro. It's not going to get paid, man.
1272, guys.
Wow. Asif is not going to get paid. And he is going to be screwed. And the sooner he realizes that, the better. But he just thinks Eddie's going to be fine and he's going to send you this money. It's not going to happen.
So understand that if you're owed money or a belt by Eddie, you're not going to get it. I'm sorry. Two, if you have a current order of a fresh current order with like a Asif or somebody like that, and you have a PayPal you're able to claim, I would contact the Asif, see if your order's been placed. If it hasn't been placed, then make that claim. If you don't want to come public, don't come public, but make that claim. Get your money.
I have some information for you guys who have been scammed. Okay. This is very, very important. Very important. So listen closely. If you paid Cash App, all right, I'm going to give you some instruction here. And shout out to the person who sent this to me. They didn't want to be revealed, so I'm going to respect their wishes. This is what they said. First, everyone needs to go into Cash App and dispute the charges due to fraud. Okay? Let me repeat that. Everyone needs to go into Cash App and dispute the charges due to fraud. If one person does it, they will lose. If 15 people do it, they will shut the Cash App down and investigate. So we need all of you, okay, to go into your Cash App if you paid Cash App and dispute it due to fraud. However, Cash App is known for scamming and their customer service department sucks. They will investigate for 30 days. Most likely they will come back and deny all the claims. Then they will need to call their banks and dispute the charges through them. So, first step, dispute the charges via Cash App. Fraud. Okay? Do that now. If that doesn't work out, call your bank. Dispute it through your bank. Give them the screenshots. Give them whatever you can to show that you haven't received anything. Because guess what? They're going to reach out to the other party and see if they have a tracking number for you, which he doesn't. Okay? Once Cash App denies it, they will need to go to the CFPB website and put a complaint in. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to show you guys this. You go here. Consumerfinance.gov. Consumerfinance.gov. Okay, put a complaint in about Cash App and that charge. Okay, people that even paid directly through friends and family to Eddie can go to this website and report it. Don't give up. Don't just say, I lost that fucking money, I'm screwed. Do something about it. even if you don't get the money back, right? Even if for some reason it doesn't work out, he's put on the map. They got eyes on him.
At least you're trying.
But you got to do something. You have three ways to do it. Dispute through Cash App fraud, consumerfinance.gov, and go through your bank. Three ways. Do all three. Do all three. Dispute the raffles. If you haven't received something and you did a raffle, it's $10. Dispute it.
Yeah, if you didn't win a belt, if you didn't get your belt in the raffle, dispute it.
Dispute it. Do it. Do it. It's not just $10 because it's 30 people. It's $300. But we got to all be in on this. We got to work together, right? He scammed a lot of people, man. A lot of people.
And adjust your feelings because you think you're piling on somebody that could be sick, could not be sick. I don't know. I'll go on record right now. I hope he makes 100% full recovery if he's sick, because you know what? I want him to pay for every single debt that imaginable. I want him to have to account for it.
Because you know what? I'm going to be frank with you guys.
Hold on.
Go ahead.
Personally, and this is where everybody's situation is different. Personally, for PTM, like Eric said, we went away. We lost 7 months of production because that dude created so much division in this hobby and stirred up so much shit. When all it takes is, yo, if you have a question, yo, you can PM Vinny. You PM him now. You can PM me. You PM Joey. You PM us now. But allowed him to create so much division. You don't like Carmine, bro, PM him. He's an entirely different person when he's not on video.
Yep. Ira's in on it. We know she is. Josh Hammer's in on it. We know he is. This is far from over. We're not done. You can't shut us the fuck up. We're going to shut you out. Okay. Next week, we're going to be here with the Mayans. We're going to go over that and exactly how he scammed them too. I appreciate every single one of you that watched tonight. Once again, like the video for me. Just click like, share this fucking video. Go to tinyurl.com/Eric Tyler. Donate what you can.
And thank you to everybody that has donated.
Thank you
already.
So much, man. For real. We appreciate it. We love you so, so much. And we'll see you next week with the Mayans. All right? We're done. Take care. Come on.